The Philippine Bureau of Internal Revenue closes down 11 branches of offshore gaming operator New Oriental Clubs 88 Corp over alleged tax violations. Let's get the details from our correspondent, Bruce Rodriguez. Bruce, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Mikey. That's right. We just came from the raid operations of the Philippine Bureau of Internal Revenue. So they again continue their clampdown on Philippine offshore gaming operators who are not paying the correct taxes and not registered at the tax agency. Now, this is in coordination with the Department of Finance, or DOF, as well as the Togo Task Force. It closed down another company here in relation to violating Section 115B or to Section.
We'll try to get back to him later on in the program. In the meantime, let's get an update on the stock market. Michelle Ong joins us live from the Philippine Stock Exchange. Hi, Mimi. Go ahead.
Hi, Mikey. Well, Philippine shares enjoying a bit of a rally, an early bounce following that heavy sell-off on very heavy volume yesterday because of that MSCI rebalancing. Today, we're actually seeing a pretty decent bounce. The index right now up by 0.8% or 64 points. We're now trading at 77.71. You've got 63 advancers, outnumbering just 60 decliners. Some of the big losers in the past couple of days seeing a bounce as well. Possibly, you know, investors taking this opportunity to buy them back up as part of bargain hunting strategy. You've got Ayala Land leading the pack, very actively bought up right now, up by 2.8%. DMCI up by 4.1%. Alliance Global by 2.6%. BDO by 1.1%. You've also got Ayala Corporation up by 2.4%. And Jollibee Foods also higher by 3.3%. It's also helping that the rest of Asia is also cheering Wall Street's performance overnight. Yet another record close for the major indices there. Investors still cheering, you know, President Donald Trump's pronouncements that they are in the final throes of that trade deal. So for today, at least, all things seem to be pointing to a positive movement for the markets, including Philippine shares. Mikey?
Thank you for that update, Mimi. Now, Bruce, in other news, the Philippine Central Bank and other microfinance stakeholders are betting on the country's national ID system to boost financial inclusion efforts. As Bruce Rodriguez tells us, the agency leading the rollout of the ID system is on track to meet registration targets despite budget concerns.
Some of the most successful micro-entrepreneurs in the Philippines again recognized at an awarding ceremony at the Central Bank's headquarters in Manila. A businessman in Mindanao brought home the top prize, with his restaurant already earning 13.4 million pesos in annual sales. He sells a famous delicacy among Muslim Filipinos called pastil, a steamed rice dish topped with dry minced beef, chicken, or fish. Other micro-entrepreneurs across the Philippines were also recognized at the annual event, with every awardee all sharing the story of borrowing money from microfinance institutions to fund their business ventures. Central Bank Governor Benjamin Diokno says these success stories are proof pushing for financial inclusion is key in addressing poverty and other socioeconomic issues in the country. For Eduardo Jimenez, vice chairperson of the Microfinance Council of the Philippines, more Filipinos will soon benefit from access to microfinance loans as the country implements its national ID system.
If you have a very clear, reliable, and an ID that can be acceptable to the lenders, not to the one that would lend money, and that is properly vetted, that would be very good for the system from a background of the person, because we have a uniform ID, you'd be easily able to assess the credit worthiness.
And it's all systems go for the ID system, as the Philippine Statistics Authority expresses confidence it can hit target rollout despite concerns of a lack of budget for the program. Senator Ralph Recto earlier said government has failed to propose a sufficient budget for the program as they deliberate on the PSA's proposed spending plan for 2020.
During our budget deliberation at the Senate, we presented that, of course, we have to have the budget, which is about 5.6 billion for 2020, to cover the target. I'm happy that the senators actually are gracious enough to understand our situation, and they promised that they will allocate the necessary budget.
Based on the PSA's experience during the pilot rollout, which started in September, it took an average of less than 10 minutes for an individual to register. This includes the screening, biometric and demographic capturing, as well as printing of the transaction slip. Government targets to enroll 14 million Filipinos and alien residents in the Philippines to the national ID system by the end of 2020. And by June 2022, it aims to have at least 100 million individuals on board the program. Bruce Rodriguez, ABS-CBN News.
Bruce Rodriguez is now back on the shutdown of a PH offshore, Philippine offshore gaming company due to tax violations. Bruce, go ahead.
Hi again, Mikey. Well, again, we just came back from the raid operations of the Philippine Bureau of Internal Revenues as they closed yet another Philippine offshore gaming operator, which has operations in Parañaque City in Metro Manila. For the day, they closed down 11 branches of a New Oriental Club 88 Corporation located at Parañaque City. And according to BIR Deputy Commissioner for Operations Group, Arnel Gubalia, this specific operator is actually the biggest operator chains here in the Philippines. So that's why he said when they found out that this certain service, POGO service provider, wasn't paying the correct taxes as well as not registered with a tax agency, they really went ahead and issued warnings to this certain company. But however, after repeated issuances of warnings of that they should pay taxes and register with the BIR, they still didn't comply. That's why right now they decided to close down the operations of this certain POGO service provider. And he explained that 11 branches of New Oriental Club 88 are not registered and not paying taxes, amounting to tax revenue losses of billions of pesos. But he said that the main branch of this specific POGO service provider, Club 88 Corporation, located in Makati City, is registered. However, they would also still go after the main branch and serve them a 48-hour notice that would tell them or that would tell them to ordering them to pay the correct taxes as well as register all the unregistered branches at the BIR. And if they don't comply with this order, Mr. Gubalia said that they'd also be forced to close down the main branch in Makati City. Now, this is amid the ongoing clampdown of illegal POGO operators here, Philippine offshore gaming operators here in the country. This is as they try to plug tax losses amounting to billions of pesos, as they really try to make sure all the POGO workers as well as the operators that they be registered under taxes as well as registered under local labor laws, including for the workers as well as the operators. Mikey.
Okay, Bruce, you mentioned tax losses. Now, the BIR's collection shortfall this year is expected to hit 104 billion pesos. This even despite higher taxes under the train law. Now, given the big shortfall, can we expect the BIR to further increase the heat on Philippine offshore gaming operations to stem that, to decrease that shortfall?
Well, while they didn't really say that this is an effort, a conscious effort to plug that shortfall, this would really help gather more revenues, tax revenues for the Philippines, as they're really expecting billions of pesos, to collect billions of pesos in taxes from these Philippine offshore gaming operators. Earlier, from the POGOs that they closed earlier, Finance Assistant Secretary Tony Lambin also told us that they've already collected around 250 million pesos from those operators that they closed. So they're expecting hundreds of millions of pesos more in the coming days, as well as a billion pesos more, of course, from this recent closure of New Oriental Club 88 Corporation. So all those collections in taxes would somehow help plug that deficiency or that estimated shortfall in tax collection. Mikey.
Okay, thank you for that, Bruce.